Hello children, today we are going to discuss about transport. Now what is transport? Transport means going from one place to another. That can be going from your homes to the school. It can be going from your home to some mall. It can be going from your home to your uncle's place or to your grandparents' place. Alright? And for all this, you need different types of vehicles in which you will travel. Or there are different ways in which you will travel. Sometimes you will have to go by road. Because if you have to go to the school, you will not find any railway which will take you from your home to the school. There you will travel by bus, and bus is a road travel transport, because bus, auto rickshaw, scooter, car, bicycle, all they travel on road. Sometimes if you have to go from Pune to your uncle's place or you to a grandparents' place, then sometimes you take the rail, that is railway. Alright, so that is also a means of transport. Alright children, so we will see a few pictures, and while watching those pictures, we will discuss what are the benefits and when do we travel by them. Alright, so let's see a few pictures.
Here are a few vehicles which move on the road, and it is called road transport. When the vehicles move on the road, it is called road transport. You can see a bus, that is a school bus. It takes the children from their homes to the school. There is an ambulance. Ambulance carries sick people, patients, from their homes to the hospital. You can see a car. You travel, you go on a vacation, sometimes using your own car. So these are different vehicles we use to go from one place to another. When you have to travel for shorter distances, that is to nearby places, you use vehicles like auto rickshaw, scooty, or even a bicycle. Children, cycling is a very good exercise. Try and cycle within the premises of your society. See how healthy and strong you will become. Children, we have seen different vehicles in which we can travel. But suppose if you want to send your car to some other place, or you want to bring that big sofa set from the shop to your house, how will you do it? For that, you have vehicles like trucks. So children, remember, there is road transport which is used by people to move around, to go from one place to another. But if you have some luggage, or maybe some furniture which has to move from one place to another, you will still use the road transport. You will use vehicles like cargo trucks, which will carry your luggage, your furniture from one place to another. Other than road transport, we also have the rail system, the railways, the trains. These trains carry people. You can travel in a train if you have to go to far off places, something that is very far. See, you can see people sitting in the train. And children, not only people, but the goods train also carries goods. Like the cargo truck carries your furniture or your car, Similarly, big things which have to go from one city to another can be taken by the train. Alright children, so this is all about our road and rail transport. Transport is moving, traveling. Traveling means to go from one place to another. It can be near your house, it can be far away from your house. Depending on that, you will decide whether you want to go walking, you want to go on a cycle, you want to take an auto rickshaw, or you need to travel by bus, or you have to take the train. So remember, this is road and rail transport. See you in the next video.